Hello friends, this is Hedda. Welcome to another video. I hope you're all having a great February so far, and if you're having trouble setting up your journal, don't worry, because today I'm going to show you 5 minimalist monthly spreads, and I promise anyone can make these. For all of these spreads, you'll only need some fine liners in different sizes, and that's pretty much it, so let's start! This first spread is a personal favorite of mine. All you're gonna do is draw some horizontal lines, and this will be your calendar grid. We're gonna pretend that it's April for this month. So I'm just writing out the letters for each day, and then I'm writing an A for April. Then all you need to do is write in the dates, and then you're done. This is one of the most minimal monthly spreads that I can think of, and it's so easy to make. I used this in March of 2018 and also in my February setup for this year, so check out that video if you'd like to watch it. This next one, we're gonna pretend it's July, and this is a one-page calendar. So on the left page, I'm just writing July in a fun font that I found on Pinterest, and then we're gonna make the calendar on the right side. Pre-made calendars are often horizontal, but this one is vertical, which means that we're gonna have 7 boxes vertically and then 5 boxes horizontally. I think this is a really fun way to change things up once in a while. Here I've written the dates in July in black and then the dates in June and August in gray. I've used this calendar multiple times, both in January and February of 2018 and also in July of 2018. The next setup I would like to show you is a pretty standard calendar. We're just gonna make a regular calendar grid. This one is horizontal like most calendars, and I'm only making squares for the actual days of the month, so it will have a little bit of a funny shape, but I think this looks really nice. I recommend using different fonts to change things up a little bit, and you could use a highlighter to add some color to the spread. And then all you need to do is just add the dates of the month, and then we're done. There's lots of room on the outside of the calendar for decoration if you want to decorate it a bit, so I think this one is a really good base. I used it in May of 2018 and also in September of 2018. For the next one, let's pretend it's May. This setup is one of the coolest ones that I've used, in my opinion. It's a vertical calendar again, but instead of squares, we're making rectangles. So this one takes up a lot more space on the page, and there isn't that much room for a decoration, but a cool font can take you further than you think. I really enjoy using the rectangles instead of squares because it actually gives you a little bit more room to write. Instead of having to use 2 lines for a certain event, you'll probably only use 1 line, and so it might be able to fit more than normal actually. I always think it's very helpful to know which week you're in. I know this might not be very common in a lot of countries, but in Norway, it's very important to know which week you're in. I've used this setup in both October of 2017 and in October of 2018. So as you can tell, I really enjoy using it. For the last monthly setup, we're gonna pretend that it's June. So we're just gonna write June on top here. And then for the calendar, it's just the dates of the month written in a vertical line like this. I used this setup in June of 2018 and also in September of 2017. And now that we've gone through all the 5 setups, let's have another look at them. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please hit the subscribe button if you'd like to see more, and that's it for now. I'll see you next time.